Hello, my rubber hearts, and welcome back. Today, we are diving into one of our frequently asked questions style mini episodes. The question is, why do different rubbers smell so different? If you worked in a mixing room or handled different elastomers, you know exactly what I mean. Natural rubber, nitrile, neoprene, they each have a distinct odor. And it's not your imagination, it's chemistry. Natural rubber usually has a strong and not very pleasant smell. That comes mostly from its processing. Raw latex contains proteins and fatty acids that break down easily, so preservatives like ammonia are added. Then, in sheet production, the rubber is often smoked, which leaves a sharp, smoky odor that sticks around even after compounding. Nitrile rubber is made from acrylonitrile and butadiene. The acrylonitrile content is what makes it oil and fume resistant, but it also gives NBR its characteristic oily or chemical smell, especially noticeable in freshly mixed compounds. Neoprene, on the other hand, based on chloroprene, is one of the most instantly recognizable. Chlorinated chemistry tends to produce pungent, biting odors, so neoprene sheets and foams always carry that sharp scent. EPDM has its own distinctive smell, often described as slightly waxy or chemical. It comes from the diene monomers and the way the polymer backbone interacts with processing oils and antioxidants. Once you've worked with EPDM in automotive or roofing, you'll know that smell immediately. Silicone rubber is the odd one out. It has little to no smell compared to organic rubbers. Its backbone is inorganic, made of silicone and oxygen, so it doesn't release the same volatile organics as other rubbers. The lack of smell is often a giveaway that you are dealing with silicone. But sometimes you do notice an odor. Not from the silicone itself, but from the curing system. Peroxide-cured silicone can leave a sharp smell, platinum-cured silicone is usually odorless, and condensation-cured RTVs often release a vinegar-like scent from acetic acid. Polyacrylate rubber has a strong acrid odor, often described as sour or vinegary. This comes from the acrylic monomers and their breakdown products. If you've ever opened a fresh batch of ACM, the smell is unmistakable. Fluoroelastomers, like Viton, are in a league of their own. They can have a sharp, almost chemical burn-type odor during processing, linked to fluorinated byproducts. If you worked with FKM in curing ovens, you'll know the smell, and you will also know why good ventilation is essential. And beyond the base polymers, additives play a big role. Accelerators can add sulfurous notes, antioxidants can give phenolic odors, and plasticizers or oils can contribute petroleum-like or sweetish scents. That's why even within one rubber type, different compounds can smell a bit different, depending on the formulation. So the answer to the question is that rubbers smell different because of their monomers, their processing, and their additives. It's chemistry in action right under your nose. And for many technologists, those smells become an instant fingerprint. You can often tell the rubber family before you even look at the data sheet. That's today's frequently asked question mini episode, my rubber hearts. Quick, practical, and maybe a little fun the next time you walk into a mixing room. Which rubber smell do you recognize instantly? Drop it in the comments. I'd love to hear your rubber perfume stories.